Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and have the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 30th of July. Over 80 killed, many will be attacked in multiple landslides in India's Kerala. Baloch protesters and army trade blame over violence in Gwalior. And Sri Lankan president fails to get backing of largest party for the election. And now for all the details. In a tragic incident, more than 80 people have lost their lives, while over 100 were injured on Tuesday in multiple landslides triggered by the rainfall in Wayanad district of India's Kerala. People wearing ponchos gathered near one of the sites as muddy water gushed through the area, while others stood on top of mounds of debris and broken trees. Rescue operations were hampered after a main bridge collapsed in the region. Relief efforts were ongoing and two helicopters of the Indian Air Force had also been mobilized. The death toll was likely to rise. The Indian Meteorological Department has forecast extremely heavy rainfall in the state. Kerala is prone to heavy rain and flooding, with nearly 400 people killed in one of the worst floods in 2018. And addressing the leaders of Indian industry, Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday highlighted the achievements of his government over the last 10 years and said India is currently the world's fastest growing major economy. Addressing the post-budget conference, PM Modi said during his tenure, the country's budget has increased 3 times to Rs 48 lakh crore from Rs 16 lakh crore. PM Modi added that investors across the world are keen on coming to India and that we should not let go of the golden chance. More than 1,000 participants from industry, the government, diplomatic community and think tanks, among others, attended the conference in person, while many connected virtually from the various CII centres across the country and overseas. And tensions have escalated in Balochistan's Gwalior, with Baloch activists claiming a brutal crackdown on their peaceful gathering. Multiple reports have suggested violent clashes between Baloch protesters and security forces have led to casualties on both sides.
Baloch activist Mehrang Baloch has vowed to continue the Baloch national gathering in Gwalior, despite what she said attempts by Pakistani authorities to scare the participants with guns. The Baloch Yakjeti Committee, spearheading the protests against enforced disappearances by security forces, has blamed there has been a brutal crackdown on peaceful protesters in Gwalior, which is under a road and communications blockade. Reports suggest at least 3 protesters and 1 army soldier have been killed in the clashes in the past 3 days, while several have been injured and detained.
3 din ke dauran hamare takriban 1000 ke kareeb saathi abhi tak giraftar hai aur hame kuch bhi nahi pata hai. 4 din ho chuke hain ki Gwalior mein network band hai aur yahan pe curfew nafiz kiya gaya hai, jahan pe FC police aur death squad ke karande har gali kuche mein aam logon ko pakad rahe hain aur unko maar rahe hain. Takriban Gwalior darne mein abhi dusri martaba hame crackdown ka samna hua hai, जिसकी वजह से एफसी और पुलिस ने आकर जो पीसफुल धरना था उसके साथ मुजाकरात करने के बजाय वहां जितने भी इंतजामी थे उन सब को मारा, उन सब पर तशद्दुद किया और अभी तक हमें कुछ नहीं पता है. पूरा शहर बंद है कि उनमें से कितने लोग जिंदा हैं और कितने लोग जख्मी हैं. ये सब रियासत पाकिस्तान की जानिब से हो रही है.
Meanwhile, protests erupted in other parts of Balochistan on Tuesday to condemn the violence. Baloch activists have long claimed their struggle for rights and self-determination is suppressed by brute force by Pakistan. Chief Minister Sarfaraz Bukhti earlier told the Balochistan Assembly that the demonstration was a conspiracy to block a foreign investors' delegation due to visit Gwalior next week. He has offered talks to ensure peace.
Moving on, the rising level of unemployment in Gilgit-Baltistan continues to be a cause of worry for the locals.
The ground reality suggests the government is hardly bothered about the concerns and aspirations of youngsters who are forced to migrate or take extreme steps. A report.
Rising unemployment is one of the primary problems of people in Gilgit-Baltistan, and residents blame blocked access to development is forcing youngsters in the occupied region to migrate. Otherwise known for its peaks and lakes, Gilgit-Baltistan is infamous for spiraling cases of suicide amongst the youth, who are forced to take the extreme step with no foreseeable future. Locals lament the successive governments have so far failed to address the issue and develop industry and create job opportunities.
Education mein kafi hum logon ne naam banaya hai aur wo mulazimat ke silsile mein wo down the country wo apna ruk kar lete hain ya abroad wo jaate hain. Iski bunyadi wajah ye hai ki yahan pe koi ek large scale pe koi jo hai इंडस्ट्री नहीं है. हुकूमत को महंगाई का और बेरोज़गारी का और जो खुदकशी के जो रोकथाम है उसके लिए हुकूमती लेवल पे ऑब्वियसली जिस तरह मैंने कहा कि एक पब्लिक पार्टनरशिप के साथ के ज़रिए जो है ना इन पे काबू किया जा सकता है, क्योंकि हुकूमत शायद के पास इतना रिसोर्स भी नहीं होगा, इतना फ़ंड भी नहीं होगा, लेकिन सिविल सोसाइटी के साथ मिलकर जो है ना इन तमाम फैक्टर्स को कंट्रोल किया जा सकता है.
Locals have long blamed years of continued neglect by Islamabad and a corrupt administrative system has made Gilgit-Baltistan the most backward region under Pakistan's rule.
Sri Lankan President Ranil Wickremesinghe on Monday failed to secure the backing of the biggest political party in parliament for his re-election, posing a major challenge to his prospects in the upcoming presidential polls. Of the various candidates, Wickremesinghe is seen as the most market and reform-friendly option. He took over the top job in July 2022 as the economy crumbled under a severe financial crisis. But with just one seat in parliament, he needs the support of the SLPP, which holds a parliamentary majority and counts former President Mahinda Rajapaksa and his brother as key members, to be a stronger contender. While the SLPP's decision is a blow to Wickremesinghe, it does not take him out of the race entirely, as he is contesting as an independent candidate and breakaway faction of the SLPP and other opposition parties are likely to support his candidature. The president election is slated for September 21. Moving on, Bangladesh observed a day of mourning on Tuesday, days after at least 150 people were killed in violent protests across the country. The agitation, which began in universities and colleges last month, flared into nationwide protests that injured thousands as security forces cracked down, leading to curfew, army patrols on the streets and internet suspension to rein in the violence. While the students have called off the protest, law enforcement agencies have started actions against those they believe were involved in the violence. Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina on Monday said the violence was an attempt by opposition BNP and Jamaat-e-Islami to put their claws to destroy the development of Bangladesh. She added the incident was not a political matter, but rather a complete act of militance. However, the BNP has denied the accusation and says the government has resorted to falsehood and convenience regarding the quota movement to hide facts. BNP leader Mirza Fakhrul Islam said the protests have shaken the foundation of the power of unelected and illegal Hasina government.
That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.